Minecraft. I don't really know how to start this. I feel like everything I would say about Minecraft has most likely already been said. It's a great game. I have tons of memories with it. It's a simple, seamless survival sandbox filled to the brim with endless creativity, it feels like. I remember playing with my older brother and cousin on our survival world for hours. I remember building my very first castle I put so much effort into. I remember finally getting a full set of diamond tools, only to fall into a pit of lava 5 minutes later because I dug straight down. I cried that day. But, let's not talk about that. This game holds a special place in my heart, and while I poured plenty of hours into the main survival mode, this button right here is where I spent the majority of my playtime. There were tons of servers to choose from, full of minigames, survival sims, skyblocks. This was Minecraft to me. If I'm being completely honest, I never really touched the survival mode unless I had another person to play with. There were loads of other things I was just more interested in doing. I wanted to play Skywars, I wanted to play survival games, I even became a Minecraft YouTuber, check that one off the bucket list. There was something about Minecraft PvP I just couldn't get enough of. I spent hours clicking that left mouse button as fast as I possibly could to maximize my PvP skills. It was fun trying out new minigames and finding new ways to play, and every server I went on had its own unique appeal to it. But there was one server in particular I found myself coming back to again and again. I remember it like it was yesterday, typing in the IP address for the very first time. us.mineplex.com. Oh my gosh, I practically lived on this server! It had all my favorite minigames, micro battles, bridges, turf wars, and who can forget about Super Smash Mobs? It was fun, it was popular, it was my favorite Minecraft server. So today I want to take a look back at this place, talk about my thoughts and memories, and talk about my nostalgia towards it, and why this server was so special to me. At one point in my life, all I literally did was play Minecraft, and I'm sure some of you can relate to that. It was the game to play at the time. I was like 12, I had nothing better to do. Survival was all fun, fine, and dandy, but after discovering minigame servers, it was like a gateway to a whole new gaming experience. I went from breeding my pet cows by my small, weak wooden shack to planting a bomb in a blocky version of Counter-Strike. It felt like Minecraft could do anything. There was so much stuff to do. You could PvP, draw, parkour. It was something I never knew I wanted. During this Minecraft craze, Mineplex was basically my second home. It was founded on January 24th, 2013, and it just so happens I started playing at the peak of its popularity. Around 2015 or so, the server was averaging around 30,000 concurrent players at all times. It was the king of all Minecraft servers for quite a while. And I think the reason for that was because of how simplistic everything was. The server itself was easy to digest for new players. A player could log in, see all the minigames displayed throughout the lobby, and hop right into the action. It was simple, quick, and accessible. The navigation was straightforward, but it also had a wide variety of minigames that were easy to understand. Like take for example the minigame Micro Battles. There are four teams of four players, and the last team standing wins. That's literally it. Everything goes, just be the last team standing. It's extremely simple, yet it can be really strategic at times. Turf Wars is another great example. There are two teams with two equal sides of land. You build cover on your side for a certain amount of time, everyone gets a bow, and for every kill you get, you conquer one row of blocks for your team's territory. Whichever team that conquers all the territory wins. It's a constant back and forth battle that gets extremely intense and addicting. The beauty of Mineplex to me was just trying out all these new games. It had a huge selection of them, the biggest selection anyone had ever seen at the time. And this diverse selection of games catered to not only casuals, but advanced players as well. Probably the most complex game on there was Champions. It had you creating custom loadouts for different classes with varying abilities, skills, weapons, and items you can equip. It had game modes like Team Deathmatch, Domination, Capture the Flag. There was so much customization it almost felt overwhelming to me. It was more on the complex side of things, but it was definitely something you could sink your teeth into. Let me ask you something. What happens when you combine Nintendo's one-of-a-kind game, Super Smash Bros., with Minecraft's iconic cast of mobs and creatures? Let's talk about Super Smash Mobs. This was my favorite thing of the whole server. Combining two of my favorite games together was like a dream come true. You had the first-person PvP action of Minecraft plus the varying abilities mechanics of Super Smash Bros. It had a wide selection of mobs that you could play as at your disposal, each one having their own feel and abilities. I found myself playing this game for hours, trying to master every mob, get every achievement. The grind for this game was non-stop. Of course, it wasn't exactly like Smash Bros. It had elements of it, but overall, it was both a breath of fresh air and a weird spin on the Smash Bros. Format. First off, you played in a first-person view. This meant that the maps had to be altered to fit that playstyle. So, all the maps were made in 3D and had more space to work with. There were only two ways of dealing damage. You could use your character abilities, or you could just aimlessly swing your fist at anyone that stood in your way. Every round, each player had 4 stocks, and instead of having a percentage meter, you had a certain amount of health. But the lower your health was, the more knockback you took. You could either die from getting knocked off the map, or by simply losing all your health. One interesting thing about this system was the only way you could regain health was by having a full hunger bar. But the way you kept your hunger bar full was by dealing damage. This forced players to get into the action even if they didn't want to, or else they couldn't maintain their hunger. It felt like there was constant action at all times. If the round was going for too long, a smash crystal would spawn in the middle of the map to wrap things up. This was essentially your final smash, and some of them were kinda crazy, not gonna lie. Honestly, I thought this minigame was a little underrated. Don't get me wrong, it had its cult following, but I felt like it should have deserved more love. With that being said, obviously every game has its faults. Some mobs were just extremely overpowered. Others were extremely hard to play, mostly because your hitbox would be so huge some players could just combo you out of existence. With maps being larger, you would occasionally find campers that would just sit in the corner and play a ranged character. This minigame wasn't perfect, it wasn't the most popular, but I had a blast with it. This is probably the thing I miss the most on Mineplex. However, this Smash Bros. Parody wasn't the only memorable thing about this server. Survival Games was the first and best battle royale that defined the whole genre, changed my frickin' mind. It was the one minigame that you couldn't escape from. You couldn't log into a server without seeing or hearing the phrase Hunger Games. You couldn't log into YouTube without seeing a video recommendation of the 200th episode of some kid's Hunger Games Let's Play. It was the one mandatory game to have on any Minecraft server, and I'm sure you guessed it by now, but Mineplex's version was always my favorite. I'm not really sure why, I just liked the way everything was set up. I liked the maps, I liked the kits, everything just felt right. Bridges was another one of my favorites. There were 4 different teams on 4 different islands. You had 10 minutes of prep time before the bridges fell and connected every island together for an all-out epic brawl. I loved seeing the different strategies everyone came up with. Your team could be making giant sky bases on their island, building giant forts in the middle. Your team could be the one leading the charge into battle. This game had a lot of freedom to do whatever it took to win. I always played with this guy I met on the server named Legolist. We weren't that bad. We would always run around and see how many kills we could get. I had to have played hours with this guy. So, Legolist, if you're somehow watching this, hey man, how's it going? Man, this server is so nostalgic. I loved it, and honestly, I don't even know why, I just couldn't get enough of it. And without it, I don't know if I'd be where I am today. And yeah, I know it sounds like I'm joking, but honestly, I don't know if I'd be where I am today as a content creator. There was once a day when all you would literally see on YouTube was Minecraft. I would always watch these YouTubers playing all these different kinds of minigames. It looked like so much fun, and they even made money off it. I couldn't believe it. I wanted to do that. And so, that's when I officially started a YouTube channel. And from that moment on, I couldn't stop doing it. It was just me, Mineplex, and my garbage laptop that could barely run the game at 30 frames per second, even with Optifine. But that didn't stop me. It still excited me every time I put out a new video. And eventually, that's when I started to learn how to edit videos and make thumbnails. As a kid, it was always a dream of mine to have the YouTube rank on Mineplex, to have that famous status everyone could see. Of course, it never happened, but it gave me motivation to make the best videos I possibly could. And with that motivation, it made me a better overall content creator in the long run. This server did a lot of things. It provided hours of entertainment. It inspired me to create content on this website, and it was something I could look forward to every single day. But nowadays, this server is sort of a barren wasteland. A place that was once filled with players and full lobbies is now a ghost town in comparison to how it used to be. It makes me kind of sad, honestly, seeing a place you grew up look like this. I know at the end of the day it's just a dumb, little old Minecraft server, but this dumb, little old Minecraft server was special to me. Around 2017, Minecraft went on a steep decline in popularity. While other servers were re-innovating and trying new things, Mineplex kind of just disappeared. There's quite a few theories regarding the decline of Mineplex's popularity. The server failed to provide fresh new games consistently. It took forever for developers to fix bugs and problems within their minigames. And their anti-cheat system was so bad, it was common to see hackers in every game you played. All these factors could have played a role in all this, but ultimately, chapters in life come to a close. The server still has a small following, averaging around 2,000 to 4,000 people a day, but it's nowhere in comparison to how it used to be. Mineplex was something else. It was fun while it lasted. I would love to see a revival of the server entirely, or at the very least, see some more Super Smash Mob players. I know I'm not the only one nostalgic for this part of Minecraft, so I would encourage you to maybe take some time out of your day, log into your most nostalgic Minecraft server, and just think about all the memories you experienced on it. Like I've mentioned before, without this server, I don't know if I'd be where I am today. I know there's some hardcore Hypixel and Badline fans out there, but Mineplex was the best server a kid could ask for back in the good old days of 2015.